Hey everybody, welcome back to Politics One. Today I'm going to be talking about the recent article titled Biden, We Stand With the Cuban People Amid Historic Protests. Now, in Cuba currently, there's a huge crisis going on down there based upon the government implementing food shortages and having the citizens of the country be without any rights and live without any fundamental and universal rights, and they are being undermined by the current government of the situation. And the situation down in Cuba is terrible. They're receiving a lot of repression, and they are living under an authoritarian regime, and all of this is happening under a government that recognizes that these citizens are not actually citizens at all, but they are instead the property of the individual government that currently runs the organizations and stipulates the laws and the rules of that nation. And so Cuba is in a huge crisis, and many of the people are protesting peacefully because of this authoritarian regime. And Biden even pledged to be respectful, to understand the Cuban crisis and the government in that situation. However, they are still receiving a lot of repression, and they're being suppressed, and all of their rights are being hindered by this authoritarian laws, these authoritarian governments, and they've been pretty much subjected to various ways of suffering by the government of Cuba. And the United States pledges solidarity with the Cuban government, or not the Cuban government, but the Cuban citizens. And so he just released a statement saying that we respect the citizens' rights to protest peacefully. This failure to respond on behalf of the government is a terrible, horrible act, and should not happen. And these governments, whoever is in power in the executive branch in terms of Cuban government and Cuban politics, should be recognizing the rights of Cuban citizens to assert their independence and to assert their protesting and their freedom of speech, so on and so forth. So this article goes over that, and as you can see, they are protesting they are actually rallying in Miami as well. And it's interesting to see and to view. They're protesting, and they're trying to figure out ways to assert their independence in a peaceful way. I highly doubt there will be some sort of violent revolution, but if there is, I believe the Cuban government is prepared to respond to that, like always, and the United States is prepared to send supplies to Cuba for the defense of the Cuban citizens, because they are exiles, and they are protesting in Cuba, and they are actually protesting in, I think Miami too, if I'm correct about that. But it seems like there is high prices because of the COVID coronavirus pandemic, and there are food shortages. And I don't think the Cuban government is doing anything about it. But it looks like the global political world, the geopolitical landscape, is definitely recognizing these Cuban citizens protesting on behalf of the government, in behalf of economic crises and stuff like that. So I think over a period of time, many Republicans are saying they stand with the Cuban citizens as well, and that's good. That's a good sign. But it looks like the Cuban government must deal with this quickly and figure out methods to kind of fix these citizen uprising. Otherwise, there may be some sort of revolution or insurrection or violent uprising, but who knows what might happen on that particular standpoint. But it looks like this is a situation that kind of interested the White House, and the White House is looking at it deeply, And so there's an important fact on this article.